Good morning, everyone. Brand new edition here of Sports Medicine Weekly on this Saturday morning. My name is Steve Cashel. So happy to be joined by my co-host this week. He is Dr. Nick Verma, subbing for Dr. Brian Cole. Dr. Verma is the head team physician for the Chicago White Sox, one of the team physicians for the Chicago Bulls, sports medicine specialist, orthopedic surgeon from Midwest Orthopedics at Rush. Our producer is Shane Reardon here at The Score. Our website is sportsmedicineweekly.com. Ready for Super Bowl Sunday, Doc?
I'm ready.
Well, let me talk.
Best day of the year.
It brings up an interesting topic here. And how sports medicine relates to those Super Bowl Sundays, Game 7 in the World Series, Game 83, right, in a basketball schedule, or Game 163 in a baseball schedule. You're the head team physician for the White Sox when they have that one wild card or play to play into the playoffs. What changes, and how does it affect your world as a team physician? And what do you guys talk about with the GM and the owner and the player who wants to continue either in the game when he gets injured or trying to give it all in that one game where they need him?
Yeah, it really is an interesting topic, Steven. It's probably something that we can't cover in the short time that we have here completely, but I think the take-home message is it really shows the difference between how we operate in our day jobs, which is taking care of regular patients that come into our office, and the complexity of the decision-making that goes into caring for the professional athlete, right? On the professional athlete side, we've got to consider the long-term prognosis, the long-term health of the athlete. But in many cases, we also got to consider the short-term. So where are we in the season? What does the season look like? Are we in playoff contention or not? Are we in playoffs? Is it Game 7 of the World Series, for example? Where's the athlete in terms of their contract? Is this a contract year for them? Is it an important year for them to be able to be on the field, even though they may be at 80 or 90%, or is this a time when we say, look, the player's got an injury, we're not going to go anywhere this year, let's shut him down and make sure we're at 100% for next year. So the decision-making undoubtedly changes when it comes to a situation like the Super Bowl or the World Series or the NBA Finals or the NCAA College Championship. And a great example is Tua a couple years back, where he had the sprained ankle. If you remember, there was a lot of hoopla about him having a procedure, and he played about 2 weeks afterwards.
Alabama quarterback.
Yeah, yep. That's an injury that for most of us, we would say 6 to 8 weeks to play. But as a physician, it comes down to decision-making about, are we confident that it's safe for the athlete to play in terms of them not doing further damage that could compromise the long-term career prospects for a guy like that? Number two is his performance going to be sufficient enough so that he can actually do the job that he needs to do on the field? And also not put himself in danger. So a quarterback who can't get out of the way, for example, of a big hit may be predisposed to a bigger injury if you let him play on a gimpy ankle. And then finally, it's always about informed consent, right? So the name of the game is making sure that the player understands the nature of their condition, the risks and benefits associated with playing versus sitting it out. And the bottom line is it comes down to a player decision once you give them all the information. But the complexity is amazing when you get to higher and higher levels of sports competition.
Well, plus you get the GM involved, the owner involved, the manager or head coach involved, plus the player agent, right?
Absolutely. To be fair, you know, our job on the physician side is we're the player advocate. So we're not in a position where if a GM says or an owner says we want this player to play, if I don't think the player can play or I don't think it's safe for him to play, then the decision is it's not safe for him to play. Obviously, the GMs and the owners, et cetera, need that information in terms of planning and deciding, do we bring somebody, you know, in the baseball world, it's do we bring somebody up in order to fill that roster spot? Are they going to be a couple days, in which case we can just leave them on the active list, or do we need to put them on the injured list? So there is some complexity in managing those situations. But by far and away, those of us in team sports recognize that our, I don't want to say allegiance, but our job is to do no harm and to make sure that player safety and player health comes first.
Great stuff. Let's move on.